What is up, heroes, and welcome to Pokemon The Keepers of Order. This is a little fan game I got sent to play, and it looks really fun. From the screenshots, it's got a bunch of Fakemon. They're not the most detailed Fakemon I've seen, but hey, everyone's got to start somewhere. It's a hell of a lot better than anything I could ever do, and some of them look pretty cute. The game's not that long, so expected to be finished in, you know, 4 or 5 episodes. And yeah, with that, let's jump right into it. Alright, new game. Ooh, we've got a king. Welcome to Biodaterra, the great world of Pokemon. I take great delight to let you know of my name, which is King Tidus. Okay. This world is inhabited by creatures we call Pokemon. People and Pokemon live together by supporting each other. I became king of the land by supporting my Pokemon, who in turn supported me to the fullest. Alright, cool. Now, will you please inform me of your name? Sweet. It's nice to have a king instead of a professor. Alright, Faultsy, there we go. Yes, it is. Faultsy, are you ready? Your very own Pokemon story is about to unfold. Unfortunately, I'm rather busy. You are a king, I guess, but I must return to my palace. Visit me whenever your heart inclines you to. Okay. Ooh. Got some secret agents. Alas, I found you, Jettik. Ooh, the music. Yes, Jettik, the one of darkness, and one of the two keepers of order. Comrades, this is a monumental event in the history of Biodaterra. We've just accomplished the first step in unearthing this world's most obscure secrets. Sir, there's a high likelihood that the one of light may be lurking here as well. I'd have to agree, as this would be consistent with the tradition of Ying Yang Town. Oh, there it goes. Nonsense! If Lunara were here, it would obviously be together with Jettik. Alright. Ooh. This conflict has been getting out of hand. I demand a resolution, effective immediately. Ooh. You have to give me a chance, Father. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. We must go after the Legendary One before we no longer can. This is what the people want. This has the potential to make our world immensely richer. I don't mean rich in terms of money. And the Cobalt Group has no compelling counter-argument. Ooh. It's like Juniper with like shades, man, and like an evil coat. Your Majesty, this has become a little much. If the Argon Group is to pursue Cherios, the safety of our land will be at risk. Life as we know it may collapse if they be successful in their pursuit. No lie, for an intro, this game's very, like, it's drawing you in really well. Your Highness, I come from a voice of reason. With that said, we must uphold caution for the perils we will face should Cherios be summoned. Nothing should be of higher priority than the safety of our citizens. Ooh, in the meantime, young Faultsy gets lost in Nisi Forest. Yet Faultsy's mum has no idea, for Faultsy had never owned any Pokemon. It was unlikely to be in the forest alone. Eventually, Faultsy gets cornered by 3 Pokemon, Leafeon, Kinlub, and Finlet. Faultsy must partner with one of the 3 to escape and return home. Okay. Which starter should we choose? So we have, I want to see a bigger picture of them. So from the sprites, I'm quite liking the water dude. He looks kind of cool. Finlet. Let me see if I can get like a bigger picture of all 3 of these. Alright, so here are some screenshots of the game. Top left, those are the starters. So we've got the grass one looks very happy, the fire one looks very moody, and the water one looks very, very shy. I think we'll go with the water one. I think he looks the coolest. I think that's what we'll go for. Alright, yo! Finlet! I'm choosing you, dude. Okay. Can we just get the rest as well? Ah, oh. Unfortunate. I was kind of hoping the game will like bug out a little bit and we can get all 3. Alright, little Finlet. It's got Torrent. Okay. Right. Let's go. So we're kind of like faking what we can find in the grass. Oh, the music. Oh, it's just like normal music, but like, I don't remember, my bass is really high, but I just could hear the bass coming in. It was like, oh yeah. Nice. Okay, got to an Aria. Looks like a a flying steel type, maybe? Like, I know the Fakemon don't look the greatest, but, you know, Fakemon aren't everything. So far, the story's quite compelling, and it's kind of drawing me in, so, yeah. To me, like, I don't really care what a game looks like, whether they use custom sprites or, you know, old Pokemon, just use, like, you know, the fire red, leaf green graphics. As long as the game's got a good story, that's all that matters to me. You know, story is everything. Okay, yo, what up? I'm so lost right now. Maybe you come down this way. I'll take you out. Yo, wanna battle? No, you don't. Don't have any Pokemon, but I still enjoy the shade here. Fair enough. What else can we find in the grass? Anything else? Got no balls to capture him, but... Oh! Dimskull. It's one of my frozen Pokeballs in his mouth. Like, yo, how many can you get? We're actually quite weak as well. We've got like 11 HP left. I should be very careful. Oof, okay. It's fine, it's fine. About to grow a level as well. Hey, level 6. Okay. Yo, what up, man? I can tell that you're a new trainer. In that case, you might want this. Hey, thank you very much, dude. Much appreciated. I kind of need that. I'm going to try and avoid some battles because I'm a bit weak, but what's down here? Dead end, okay. Great way to avoid some battles. Ooh, that's cute. Pitiful. Oh, dude. Wish I could catch some of you guys right now, but unfortunately I can't. Not yet, anyway. Not yet. Alright, let's keep going down, and I think we're going to be back to our town of Nisi Island. Yo, what up, girl? Never been in that Nisi Forest. Too scared of the dark. Oh, that's a shame. It's pretty nice in there. Though I'm not sure how I'll get back to where the starters were, because like once you come down, you can't get back up. Right, it's got a map, Pokemon Center. There's a lot of buildings here, so we've got a lot to explore. Hope to get some free stuff, because free stuff is best stuff. And actually, one thing I love to see is what the layout of a region looks like in any Pokemon fan game. So I'm going to do that right now. Ooh. The creators of this is a short game. You can probably do it in one sitting. But of all this, this looks quite long, to be honest. Like, for a short game, that's a lot of region. Is there like maybe a gym here? Because I guess we can do like one gym. It's pretty enough, like 8 gyms, if we're even doing gyms in this game. Oh, there's 4 gym badges, or whatever it's going to be. Pokedex 1 out of 4. Wait, what? 1 out of 4? Oh, okay, it's just saying, like, we've caught 1 and seen 4. Okay, I was about to say, what do you mean, like, have we caught 1 out of 4 potential Pokemon? That can't be right. Oh, no. Me just, not fully understanding right away. Right, ooh, got a beach here. With some houses you can't enter, okay. A lot of houses that you can't enter, okay. An empty house. It's our house. Got a PC. Anything in the box for us? Hey, get that potion. I'm assuming this is probably our house. Not too sure. Alright, let's try to explore all the buildings. Can't go in this. Can't go in this. Okay. I live in here in Nisi Island. It is expensive. For good reason. What a lovely day it is. It's quite nice. So I guess you're going to go in the house with the door, with the doors open. Like, Jimmy wants to become a strong trainer one day, but his parents won't let him yet. Oof. Well, being a trainer must be so fun. It is, kid. In your face, you suck. wait, where are we even going? We came from this way. Do we go in here? Oh, this is our mum. Yo. Dear, where have you been? It's the forest. What's that? You're in the forest? You're all alone? Honey, you know how dangerous that is. Do I have a Pokemon with you? Yep, let me heal it then. Thank you very much, appreciate it, but I already got it healed at the Pokemon Center. I'm sorry, Volty, I had no idea. In any case, you might want this. Ooh, a town map, thank you. That right there is a town map. Should refer to it anytime you get lost here. Okay. It's not okay with you going out without my permission. Just because you're fine now doesn't mean you weren't wrong to go out in the first place. I only say this because of how much I care about you. In the meantime, I guess you can... Oh! Bolty, we have to leave now! Whoa, earthquake! Listen, it's imperative that you all follow instructions so that nobody gets left behind. We already have a team searching every house to evacuate everyone. Gonna ask that you all board the boat and be patient until we get the signal to go. Okay. I'm so sorry, Volti. So sorry this had to happen. Guess the volcano erupted, but the boat fled the eruption of Nisi Mountain with nearly the whole city. Far past its maximum capacity, okay. If anyone had happened to be left behind, their chance of survival would be just about zero. Oof. As the inhabitants of Nisi Island fled to Ozentown, King Titus travelled there as well to give the people a speech. Okay. Been in, but I guess we do it again. Let me come and have it. Okay, a potion. Sweet. Thanks, Nurse Joy. Appreciate it. And now, can we leave? Alright, so our first train of battle it is. Who do you think you are? Because I bet you're no match for me and my Dimskull. Oh, we'll see about that, man. Alright, Youngster Diamond. Cool name, dude. Level 5 Dimskull. Okay. Let's see about that. Let's go for a nice water gun. Yeah, not too much damage. Oh, what did it eat? We're just about gonna win this. If we get hit with a crit, it's over. Oh, man. 7 HP. That dude. Not pulling any punches, is he? He's going straight for it. But I grew a lot. Alright, nice. Let's go check. Wait, let's check the map, see where we're going first. Because I want to go the wrong way to go exploring. But hidden cave. Bristol Cave. Guessing the cave probably takes us to Kapal City. We want to go to Makasa Town, guessing. But let's see if we can get to the hidden cave and stuff first, because that sounds pretty fun. Ooh, there's some trainers. Yo! What a lovely day. It is. A beautiful morning. For a second, I saw the petiphor, I saw the P, and I went straight to the 3, and my eyes just made the 3 look like a 9. And I honestly thought it was level 9, I was going to get absolutely wrecked. But luckily, it's level 3. Now he does 3 damage, and we can just tackle this bad boy out. Nice. And now we just got to do the last Pokemon. That should be fine. A few water guns, all good. Quick attack, okay. How much damage did that do? 3 damage. We should live another quick attack. Nice. Should have 1 HP left. Nice. Oh. Okay. Level 8. Cool. Alright, I'm going to go heal up. I'll see you guys back here in a second. Alright, we're back nice and healthy. Let's continue up. Got level 4 Dim Skull. Okay. We're just... go for a nice water gun. It's level 4, get the XP, you might as well. No reason not to. Although these things are quite scary. 5 damage. So we're gonna take like 10 damage overall. That really oh wait, no, even for Growl. Good. Good. Gotta save that damage, man. We'll save that HP. Alright, let's keep going up. Yo, please have some like ground or rock types and we can just destroy them super fast. Lamia? That looks like it's electric type. Ooh, okay. Lamina. It's gonna be Lamina, right? Okay, cool. Your tail to me screams electric type. Just don't have any electric moves, please, because that would wreck me. Tackle. Okay, I think we're good. So the good thing about a lot of electric Pokemon that are very... there's a Fakemon, but usually in Pokemon, like a lot of like early level electric Pokemon never have any electric type moves. There's always like tackle, growl and stuff, and you're just like, okay, good. Good. Wait, isn't this the cave that that legendary ran to? I think it might be. And we'll see soon enough. Oh. Dim Skull. I don't know what I want to capture at the moment. It's more interesting training my finlet. My little finlet. Potion. But it's not like, oh, we need to get some repels to encounter it. Oh, whoa, hello. Hatchling. Look kind of cute. Yeah, I don't think it's the area the legendary Pokemon ran to. It just kind of looked like it a little bit, but we'll see once we can actually get to the hidden cave. If we can get there. It's always good to explore this area now because we don't want to come here, you know, later on. And the trainers be level like 3 or 4 and we're level like 50. Oh my goodness. Ooh. Hamogor. I'm gonna catch it. This thing looks kinda cool. Oh dude. Okay. Horn attack? You haven't got a horn. What's that? Yeah, you got a little one actually. Oh, okay, no, it's gonna be rock type. Just one shot of a water gun, nice. Hey, we're level 10. Alright, nice. Yeah, if we don't run. Just, no encounters. No, yeah, this was the cave, yeah, here. Oh. Seems as if Lunarum wants to show you something, okay. Oh. Okay. Just following us. I can't see where we're going, but alright. Just try and capture it. Oh, whoa, big alpha crystal. Okay. So now he's gone. We got a crystal? Which isn't in any of the bags. Right, I'm guessing that'll be important for later on. Alright, cool, got an alpha crystal. Anything else in here? No, lots of dead ends. Okay. So I guess I'll just make my way back. So this is the, was it Ozen Passage? So where are we on the map? So we must have just gone to Bristol Cave? And the Hidden Cave, I can't really get to without Surf and Waterfall, it looks like. So I guess we'll just have to leave that for now and then head to the next town. Alright, cool. Right. But I think our in this part here, next episode we'll start by like where our mum was and we'll just start heading south towards the next town. But yeah, this game. Draw me in actually, it's actually quite compelling. Thank you guys for watching, I'll catch you guys next time. Have a great day. Peace.